Blog Talk Radio.
Listen, we got our guest coming on now, Catherine Mayfield, and she's written an excellent book called Bullied, Why You Feel Bad Inside and What to Do About It. I want to welcome Catherine to the show. Catherine, how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing fine. Thank you.
Tell the listeners, why did you write this book and what is the book about?
Well, I wrote this book because there are tremendous efforts being made to stop the bullying epidemic, but they're not really successful. And in my opinion, the way the government and the schools are handling bullying by saying, you can't do that, you have to stop or else, is really modeling the behavior they're trying to stop. They're showing bullies that you get what you want by forcing someone to do it your way. And I think that we need a much more humanistic, supportive approach to stopping the epidemic. And I think what's missing is the heart and soul of the kids, the bullies, and the victims. We need to help them learn how to manage their emotions and express them in a healthy way so they don't need to act out and bully other kids or, sadly, take their life in response to bullying. And that's really why I wrote the book, is because I saw more and more teens having nowhere else to turn because, like you said, they're holding all this stuff inside. They don't have any place to talk about it. And what the book does is it gives kids some information about emotional intelligence so they can learn how to manage their emotions and express them in a healthy way. When I was a teenager, I know I was pretty overwhelmed by my feelings. And I didn't see anybody else out there expressing feelings, so I thought I was defective. And that's what I'm afraid is going on, is that these kids that are having so much pain about being bullied, is they don't see anybody else in pain because all of us are hiding our emotions, and so they think there's something wrong with them. So I wrote the book to tell them, you know, here's someone who has survived emotional abuse and bullying. It's possible to recover from this kind of trauma, and to let them know that somebody cares, somebody knows that they're feeling stuff inside and wants to help them get over it. And I'm hoping that's what it'll do.
You know, I have the million-dollar question here, and it's always really racked my brain. What causes someone else to bully? What are the actions that make a bully want to bully somebody?
See, I think it's the same thing, actually, and I have a chapter called For Bullies, If You're So Mad Inside That You Want to Hurt Someone. I think that someone who is bullying is doing it because they're feeling very small, because they're feeling weak and powerless, you know, from whatever's happening in their life. Maybe their parents are bullying them or their boss is bullying them and they're going to bully another employee. But I think they're just passing on the anger and the pain.
What makes your approach in this book different from all the other approaches to bullying?
The reason it's different is that it explains emotional intelligence, which we've had literature about before, but nobody has really ever explained what it is and how you do it. So this book explains emotional intelligence. It offers a simple plan, which is not easy, but it's a simple four-step plan for learning how to manage feelings. There are a number of suggestions for expressing all the emotions, sadness, anger, frustration, anxiety. There are tips for coping with bullies and interviews with psychologists and people who have actually taken steps to recover. So it's kind of a guidebook for recovering from it all. There's also a section for people or teens who are thinking about suicide. Some things to think about, a video to watch, a list of hotlines, and there are resources for building self-esteem. And actually, quotes from famous people over the centuries, like Ralph Waldo Emerson, a lot of other famous people that show us that people have been talking about feelings for centuries. I think we just sort of stopped talking about them and got a stiff upper lip in this country and started feeling like, you know, our society doesn't really encourage people to express emotion. And in fact, lots of times there's kind of an indication or a feeling that it's a little crazy to express emotion compared to like Greeks and Italians, and I'm generalizing here, and I don't normally like to do that, but I think people in other countries are a little more expressive, a little more able to run through their anger and it's over and done. you know, instead of holding it inside and holding it inside until it explodes in bullying or road rage or an ulcer, heart disease, you know, we just have to learn how to express our feelings if we want to be healthy, mentally, emotionally, physically.